Hello everyone, I'm Zach and welcome back to another Hit Film Tutorial. Today, I'll be sharing my top 5 tips for recreating title sequences in Hit Film. Choosing a custom font is an essential step in recreating a title sequence. You can use websites like thefont.com to find free fonts with a similar style and feel to your reference. You may not find an exact match for your font, but try to find something similar that gets across the same idea. For example, if you were creating a Marvel title, you'd want to use a bold, epic-looking font, not just the default Arial that comes with your operating system. Many titles for trailers and films use 3D text to add to that big blockbuster feel. Hit Film has many tools for creating 3D text, but it's up to you to decide which one is right for your project. The Surface Studio effect is great for crumbling and cracked text, like the Justice League title, or metallic beveled text like the Mortal Kombat title. The geometry effects are great for adding full 3D text right inside Hit Film. The Boris Effects plugins are also great ways to create 3D text, and they're great for when you need your text to type on with a cool animation, or for when you want to add detailed textures to the sides of the letters. You can also create your text as a 3D model in a software like Blender. This gives you the most control over your text, even allowing you to use animated textures in Hit Film. My next tip is to break down the title into small pieces and to figure out how to do each piece individually, instead of looking at the title as a whole. Most titles are built up of many layers that add together to create the final effect. For example, when I broke down the Black Widow title, there were many light flares, floating particles, and fog and clouds in the background. All of these seemingly small details add together to make a much more interesting title. Another important detail to pay attention to is the animation, or how the title moves. When working with keyframe animation in Hit Film, make sure to use the value graph to fine-tune the result. You can add a curve to make the animation accelerate, or you can leave it as linear to give a constant motion. Check out our tutorial on the value graph to learn more about animating in Hit Film. My next tip is to try to make your title sequence procedural, which means you can change out an asset without having to redo all the work. If possible, try to make your project file like a template, so it's easy to type in different text afterwards. A good example of this is the Justice League title. Each text layer is in its own composite shot, making it super easy to change out the text. However, for the 3D Marvel intro, the text had to be figured out beforehand, because it was baked into the 3D model. When creating your title, you can use the grid effect to help you center the text, and to determine if it's too close to the edge of the frame. Just make sure to hide this layer before you export. And those have been my top 5 tips for recreating title sequences in Hit Film. If you have any tips of your own, be sure to share them in the comments below. Check out these other videos to learn more about creating title sequences in Hit Film. Remember to subscribe for more tutorials like this, and be sure to give this video a like. See you next time!